Today I'm going to talk about the common pitfalls of bag buying and what bags don't hold their value. Hey everyone, so today I'm going to talk about bags that don't hold their value. So the common belief is that bags, usually they depreciate and they don't hold their value. But in my other video, I talk about how bags hold their value and can even go up. So if you have not watched that video, be sure to watch that video after watching this video. Today I'm going to talk about the common pitfalls of bag buying and what bags don't hold their value. Number one is seasonal bags. So brands like Chanel create a lot of seasonal bags. Bags that are similar to their classic designs, but not quite. Sometimes maybe they have a brooch here and there, maybe they have a patch here and there, a pin here and there, maybe the strap is made with different materials, maybe the bag itself is made with different materials, or the size is slightly different, the dimensions are slightly different from its classic flap. These are just some examples of Chanel seasonal designs that tend to decrease in value a lot after the season is gone. And usually for people who buy seasonal bags, people buy them to use them. And after the season is gone, after people finish using them and feel that the trend is over, when they want to sell these bags, they end up finding that these bags are no longer as valuable as they thought. So seasonal bags are definitely the number one pitfall in bag buying, and it marks the number one characteristic of bags that don't hold their value. Number two is odd colors. And so the classy colors, in my opinion, are black with gold hardware, black with silver hardware, beige with gold hardware, beige with silver hardware, and certain shades of pink, but not all. So pink is a risk that you have to take. Usually not hot pink, because hot pink is also an odd color that might be hard to sell. And so odd colors also include neon colors, or just colors that are not the classy colors that I just listed. These bags tend to be harder to sell, and also they tend to sell at a lower price range. So if you want to know if your color will sell well, you can just go to any pre-loved bag website, let's say eBay, look at the sold listings and see which price do these bags sell at what color, what condition, and what style. Then you can get a better sense of how much certain bags will sell for, how much certain colors will sell for, and so forth. And number three is certain brands. Certain brands like even Dior, or some contemporary brands like Michael Kors, or Coach, or Kate Spade. And you might wonder, how come Dior made it on the list? Because even Dior is a very high-end brand, I found it super difficult to sell Dior bags. And I should have known better, because if I've done my research on Dior bags on eBay, I would have known that Dior bags are just in general selling at a much lower price for whatever reason. Maybe the demand is not as high, or maybe Dior bags just don't sell well. That is just a fact that I've experienced myself. And so if you're thinking of buying a Dior bag, buy for the reason that you like the bag and not for the reason that you want to sell the bag, because the bag is not going to sell well. Number four is odd material. So Chanel came up with the PVC material, this PVC classic flap, and a lot of people love it, a lot of bloggers wear it, but it is not very good for selling. It does not retain its value very well because the market for PVC classic flaps is just so small. Not a lot of people like PVC. Personally, I don't see the beauty in PVC. I think of it as more of a trendy and stylish style, but it is just not something that will remain timeless and classy. Another material is metallic. Metallic classic flap also tends to sell at a much lower price point. And also striped metallic also sells at a much lower price point. Again, if you want to see what materials sell well, you can just look at the sold listings on eBay or even on other resale markets, and you can see what materials sell well, what materials don't sell well. Last but not least, we're going to talk about a very risky category, which is limited edition. So it's kind of like seasonal bags, but limited edition. LV, Louis Vuitton, comes up with a lot of limited edition items, some collaborations with other brands. Some of them do super well. Some of them have a very good collector's value or resale value, but it is a risk that people have to take. For example, the Takashi Murakami collection does really well. The cherry collection that Kylie Jenner wore and a lot of celebrities wore, that collection did very well. But a lot of other collections that you probably can't think of the name because it did not do well, they don't do well in the resale market. So it is definitely a risk that you have to take. So for a beginner who is beginning to sell bags in the resale market, I really recommend you to tackle the classic designs first, tackle the timeless design first, and think about the limited edition items later. Because limited edition items, they tend to be more expensive, and it is also a risk. You don't know whether or not they'll sell well. So here are the common pitfalls in buying bags for bag value retention. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe for more videos like this. Also, hit the bell button because I make videos every single day and upload every single day. So you'll get to see my daily upload notifications. Thank you so much for watching and see you in my next video. Bye. Number one, there's seasonal bags. So as we, because the market for PVC flat bags are just so small.